What's going on, guys, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. So today we're going to be pretty much mating these Dodicaruses, creating the incubation station a little bit more, crafting up some stuff. I went ahead and did everything, crafted up like two air conditioners, a ton of everything, really, in order to get this going, because I really want to start hatching some dinosaurs. We're just going to start with the Dodicaruses kind of as a test. I don't really want to start with something big like a T-Rex because they'll take a really long time. But first we pretty much need a mating area, and I thought I'd be able to do it inside. Whoops, I just crafted a gate. Didn't mean to do that. Just throw that in here. Let's get rid of these so we don't accidentally miscraft them. So we need to do like kind of a pen for them to mate in, which is going to be something really small because they have to be touching each other or close enough to each other to be able to do something like that. So we're going to start and probably do it out here. I'm not sure why these are being really weird. Are these stone fence foundations? Oh, they are. I crafted the wrong thing. That's fine. We'll figure this out here. What I could do is we start the stone fence foundation. We go ahead and we just pop it out here. Nice and easy. Right along the edge here. And then we snap it here. And we'll go grab some more of these. I thought I crafted the stone fences, but I think I just misclicked and crafted the fence foundations instead. That's fine. So here we go. It's actually a good thing that I created that gateway then. And that should be small enough. And then we actually can craft the actual gateway, which is right here. We just need a bit of stone and a bit of wood, which we can just go get real quick. Because once we have that, we can have our little really squished up gate, enabling the dinosaurs to be close enough to mate. It's going to be big enough for T-Rexes to squeeze in there. It's going to be big enough for pretty much every dinosaur to squeeze in there and to mate. And then we just need to bring the fertilized egg upstairs. We need to set up the air conditioners and everything. And then from there, we should have an egg that's going to start to hatch. And like I said, the hatching of the eggs is a little bit expedited on my server, so it shouldn't be that too long of a thing. I think a T-Rex is about a half hour, so a Dodicarus could be probably around 5 to 10 minutes. You can actually, like, see it mature, unlike the video that you guys saw before from me with that T-Rex, where it was gruesome. It was, like, 10 minutes for the last slither, and it was, like, 4 hours for the whole gestation process. It was just really, really awful. Let's go ahead and craft up that gate. There we go. That makes everything better. And then let's head on over. Seems like lately I've been having a lot of little things go wrong. Not really wrong, but like a lot of little things that I forget to prepare for. Like this gate. I wasn't exactly prepared for this. A good thing I accidentally crafted part of it and kept it in mind that I did craft part of it. We're out of water. We're going to need to go get some. There we go. Alright. So then we just place the gate right here. And then we grab some extra walls that I should have laying around somewhere, I hope. Here we go. If we don't have any walls laying around somewhere, I might just have to craft some up. They don't really take that long, and they don't need to be that tall. Do I have any walls laying around? I think this is the bin with all the stuff that's going to be used for the incubation station. I'm going to go ahead and just roll out Mr. Dodicarus here. Also, this is back-to-back recorded. I just changed my shirt, so I don't have the names of the dinosaurs yet. I will be doing that next episode because I'm not back-to-back recording anymore. And let's go ahead and just over here and hit up a rock real quick. Just get 4 walls, which is like absolutely nothing. There we go. Do I have any wood on me? Actually, I don't have any wood on me. I need to go hit a tree real quick. Stay here, buddy. I go whack a tree. Like I said, the egg process isn't going to take that long. So it should be nice and quick. Nice, quick, easy episode to get a little baby Dodicarus. The issue is the maturation process. I kind of have something to do in a bit here. So I don't know if the baby that I'm even hatching, I'm going to give full attention to and probably just let it die. But by the next episode, I'll just do it again and I'll have one ready for you guys because I have something that came up and I need to get to, which is kind of suckish, but it is what it is. And it will almost look like it didn't happen. I probably shouldn't even told you because you wouldn't even notice, but it's whatever. Just wanted to show and test the incubation station. Plus, I don't really need a baby Dodicarus. Having three Dodicaruses serves no purpose at all. Unless I set them on wandering in the area and they get a whole bunch of stone, but then they have to defend for themselves, and then they also have to be in a cage or they'll wander way too far. So it's just kind of a test of the place that I'm building now. So, and it should be a good test. See how it works. This guy is still hungry. I need to get him some berries very soon, or he's gonna end up starving to death. All right, let's go ahead and toss him in the cage. There you go, buddy. And I believe the walls are on him. No, they're not. They're on me. It doesn't matter which way the walls face. Again, this is all a test. All right, we're going to grab the other Dodicarus. So four Royal and Dodicarus are going to mate. Here we go. I'm gonna watch it as it goes down. So we're gonna set you to wandering. And we're gonna set you to wandering. So here's the mating process. It is going up. There we go. We're gonna have a baby here very soon. It's gonna be mating with a level 31 and a level 54, so it should be pretty good. And he's just gonna pop out a little fertilized egg pretty soon. I'm not sure. Yeah, no, they're definitely not mammals, I would say. So they're definitely going to have an egg. And then from there, we're going to hold on to the fertilized egg and hope that the health doesn't go down too quickly, because we just need to craft and put down the generator and stuff. Probably should have done it first before mating. I mean, I can even start it now. It's probably a good idea. I'm going to close the gate so they don't wander out of there, though. So let's go ahead and grab the generator and get this all hooked up. There we go. Generator. We're going to put it probably just right in the middle, so that it does hook up to everything that I need it to hook up to. And then we'll do the incline in one direction with the outlet. Probably just put it straight up here. Right in the middle, pretty much. Eh, there we go. Is it not gonna let me do that? Yeah, it's not. It doesn't look like it's gonna let me do that, so let's do it this direction. Sure, why not? I guess it'll work. Hopefully it still reaches the elevator that I'm going to be setting up eventually. I'm not going to do the elevator right away. Actually, we might as well just do the elevator right now, because this will lead to the next floor. Ooh, is that wrong? Can I place? Might have to break this, which sucks because they're so hard to craft. Can I place it? Elevator platform is obstructed. Okay, so we're going to have to build this outside, I believe. Because I don't think I have enough room in here. We'll build it outside. It's not an issue for right now, though. We'll just demolish that thing. We're going to drop some of the extra heavy stuff we have on us, so that we can go put all this freaking mass amount of metal away. We'll put the elevator outside and we'll figure out a system to get dinosaurs up and down. Believe you me. We'll probably just put it at the back door. There we go. And let's just check on the baby. For now, I'm gonna probably put just a ladder right there. Get a little bit of wood and get a ladder going. Alright, so they're done mating. Alright. Did you have any luck? Disable wandering. Gestation process. Okay, so they are mammals. Okay. This actually helps me so much. But the issue is here. One, he's on wandering still. She is. Stop, please. Okay, so I guess we're not going to be doing the incubation station today. We're just going to watch this become a baby popping out. And then we have to wait for the maturation process, which is going to take a bit. I'm going to roll him on down to the water. I'm going to get him a whole bunch of, or her, a whole bunch of berries. And get that going. I thought these guys were going to lay eggs, but I'm stupid. and they don't lay eggs because they're mammals. Or something like that. Alright, let's go ahead and get you some berries. I need to roll down to the water, though. And then we're gonna have a baby Dodicarus on our hands. A cute little adorable baby Dodicarus. And the next- Oh! Fucking snake out of nowhere. Get wrecked, nerd. Alright. Let me just keep getting you some berries because you're so damn hungry. Here we go. Eat some berries. You're a growing mother. You need the berries. Gestation process is actually going to take a good chunk of time. I mean, it's already gone by and it's only been a minute, so. It's not bad. Not a bad chunk for just a minute. Just going to keep on getting you some berries to fill you on up. And then we're going to roll you home. You're going to have your baby. I'm going to have to feed the shit out of the baby, even though I don't have any berries, but that'll be next episode, because it's going to take way too long for that shit to happen. Here we go. Whole bunch of berries for you, bud. Here we are. That should be helping with your hunger a bit. I'm going to get him a little, or her a little bit more, just to make it a little better. You know, if I was pregnant, I'd want to eat the whole time I was pregnant. You know? I like eating in general. And this is a really weird conversation that we're having. And I'm going to avoid any more of this conversation that we're having in general because it could get really weird really quick. Here we go. I have two species X seeds. I did hear that there was a bug that you could get them from the swamp biome. It is now confirmed. Boop and a boop and a boop and a boop. That should fill you up if nothing else does. Alright, let's roll him on home. Or her. I don't know why I keep saying him. I'm so used to having a guy for a Dodicarus, I suppose. Her favorite is Marberries. Okay, that's good to keep in mind. Got 5,000 food. That's absolutely insane because one berry is like 30 food. So I'm going to pick a little bit more berries. So I don't think we have quite enough yet. And then roll her on home. And I thought we were going to have an egg on our hands. But I guess for now I can figure out the whole elevator thing while this thing is gestating. Gestating? Is that proper? I don't really know. Alright. The only thing I'm afraid of right now is that thing that I have to go do. I might be late to it due to this. Because with an egg, I really don't have to watch it. I have to wait till it hatches, but it usually goes a little quicker. I was thinking, like, these are armadillos. They're probably mammoths. Or not mammoths. Mammals. Which could create some issues for me. And I was like, well, we're just gonna hope and pray that the game is wrong and just gives it eggs for some reason. Because that's what they pretty much originally did. A lot of mammals laid eggs for no reason in this game, I think. Now that I think of it, I have no idea. Most of them were reptiles, right? Most dinosaurs are reptiles. So, well, whatever. Let's hop on inside. You stay there while I build up some stuff. We might not see it hatch this episode, but we'll probably see it next episode. Because it's going to take a little bit longer than I suspected. Alright, so let's go ahead and get the air conditioners upstairs. Let's go ahead and get the ladders crafted up just to get to the... Actually, fuck it. We're going to figure out the elevator. I wanted to originally put the elevator here, but I was like, wait, but it's a door. We don't want to block the door. But I don't care about blocking the back door. I more care about not being able to get my dinosaurs in and out from the upstairs when they do hatch because they're too big for a door. So, that being said... We can do the elevator right out here, as close to this as we can get. I want to center it. I don't want it to be snapped, so what I could do is have it. I want to see how big it is. Okay, So it only goes to about right before that little red leaf that I'm seeing. So we're going to do it right before the little red leaf that I'm seeing. And then we have this right here. There's the elevator. That's almost perfect. And then we just need to have this go high enough. It's unpowered, but we can figure that out here in just a second. All right. And then what we can do is we can get another cable going. Right, guys, I had a little malfunction with the recording. It just kind of like cut out on me, skipped out. I think I ran out of hard drive room, so I deleted some stuff, and that seemed to have fixed it. So I was just about to craft up the electrical stuff just to make this work a little bit better. So I was going to go to the fabricator, get an electrical cable all crafted up. Nice and easy-like. And this should be pretty simple. Compository, no, it should be... Structures, electrical, there we go. Okay. Turn that on. Craft that up. Nice and easy. We're just going to turn it off, we're not going to use it again. Actually, we will for the electrical outlet, I'm stupid. We're going to get that just jutted out a little bit more, that should reach now. We might just do another one just to be safe. And drink some water. Turn it on again. I'm just going to leave it on for now and just take out the gasoline instead. Structures, electrical. We're honestly just going to do one more to be safe. I don't know if I have three electronics. I did break down one thing. I think it only gave me two electronics, though. Where did they go? There they are. Oh, they gave me 10. Okay, I'm fine here. A little bit more metal. A little bit of polymer. We'll just all throw this in the inside the fabricator because this is where it's used anyway. And structures, electrical, outlet. We need a little bit of wood, which I don't have. I'll just fly out on Keybert real quick, get that going. We're going to check on Mrs.'s gestation. Not even about half yet, so like I said, this is going to have to happen next episode, unfortunately. No little baby dodecorus quite yet. There we go. Just a little bit of wood, and then we can get our electrical outlet going. And then that will lead to the elevator working, and then that elevator will lead up to the second floor, which is where I'm going to be hatching the eggs when there are babies. Then I take them out onto the elevator, and I bring them down to the outside area, which is going to be set up warm enough for the egg to hatch. The reason why we're doing it outside, I don't even know if we're going to do it outside. I might just set up the air conditioners and stuff in an outside area somewhere, just like out here. I'm pretty sure you can set up air conditioners outside without issue. So I'm just going to electrical cable straight out the door as far as possible, because I think all the electricity stuff is going to be outside. And there we go. I think we're going to do one more straight electrical cable right out the door. Structures, electrical. There we go. Craft. Throw the wood in there. Craft this up too. Hold on to those. We might need them. There we go. Okay. All so far so good. And then 9, that's all powered. Oh, we need to put some gasoline in here. Move your tail, dum-dum. All right, gasoline, throw that in here. That's all powered, so now we can elevate. As long as the dinosaur is not too heavy, we'll be able to elevate. I guess we're going to the top floor. Maybe we could set up our... I mean, we could even set up the room up here. Not even the room, we could just set up everything up here. I'm pretty sure the outlet would reach. I'm not sure though. This is a pretty appropriate elevator. We can just, I mean, you can stop it on the second floor as well. So we elevate and then we stop here and then we're on the second floor. Nice and easy. Or we can just delete the top one. If we demolish the top one, then the highest it'll go is right here. And I think if we delete one more, then we're going to be too low. But too low, I think I'm fine with where we're at right now. De-elevate. This thing is a little buggy when the server lags out a little bit. There we go. And then we have the elevator set up. And I can take dinosaurs, as long as they're not too heavy, onto that elevator. And bring them up into the room that will keep the eggs nice and warm. But like I said, I'd pretty much just walk the eggs up there myself and then get them warm enough. And then this is more for transporting the baby dinosaurs downstairs into here. So we are going to be doing the air conditioners upstairs, like I said. So let's go ahead and grab those real quick. Two air conditioners. And we're going to be, again, putting those upstairs. So I just de-elevate about right here. And then we're good. And we'll just put the air conditioners. Let's put one right here. That's powered. And we'll probably put one, like, right here, which is unpowered. Shit. I thought that would be powered at that range, but I forgot that I brought it all the way out here. Maybe I should have a second generator, or deleting this and just crafting another one would pretty much make this a little bit easier. The only issue is I'm losing half of the electronics every time I do this. Electronics are obnoxious to make. But it's fine. We live close to some mountains that have obsidian. We have underwater caves over by where my other base is with the Mosasaurus. It's crazy easy, so I'm not really worried. It's just a lot of off-camera stuff that sucks. So we have the elevator crafted up. We have the air conditioners upstairs. I'm going to go set up the campfires a bit as well to keep it nice and warm up there. The thing is with the swamp biome, it's great. It's absolutely epic for actually keeping dinosaurs warm because it's already inherently warm. Like, it's 35 degrees Celsius here, which means I might not even need campfires, but I'm going to do it just to be safe. I need to remember to stop closing this door. Can we crouch in? We can. Okay. Just stop closing the door so that we can get up a lot easier. And then we're probably just going to kind of circle up some campfires around here. Leading over to the other air conditioner that would be right here. And then, of course, we'll have our backup campfires. I will always have wood in them, just in between. I don't think I grabbed the extra campfires that I think I need. Oh, I did. Okay. Go ahead and grab those. Slap them down here. All right, so we got a gestation room, or a maturation room. We have everything we need, pretty much. And when this little baby is born, I will be back in the next episode, I guess. So, yeah. I'll see you in the next one. I'm sorry if it was a shorter episode. Again, I have something to do, and it's probably why I was talking out my ass today, because when I have stuff to do and I'm getting close to a schedule, I start to get a little anxious, and when I get anxious, I just start to blabber on about sweet nothings. So, yeah, sorry for the broken episode, but, I mean, it worked out. We're going to have a baby Dodicarus soon, and then we'll probably start taming some more dinosaurs so that we can have babies of those. We'll probably have a main base built up pretty soon for storing dinosaurs as well. Probably block this in with walls pretty soon. There's a whole bunch of stuff that I want to do with the swamp biome. So it's really cool. So thank you guys for stopping by today's episode, and we'll see you in the next one. Adios.